Hey guys, this is going to be your Twin Flames Tarot Scope for February 20th through the 31st. just kind of giggling to myself because I'm here washing clothes today. And I just realized that I had like my laundry in the background. So, and I already started posting the singles video. So for all you singles out there, y'all know what it's like. You're probably washing clothes today too. So I moved them so they weren't in the background. Sorry guys. Oh well, what are you going to do? I still got to do personal stuff when I'm at work too, right? All right, Twin Flames, 20th through the 31st. Okay, so first off, a chunk of cards came out. And that means information integration. I'm not sure if you can access the information or if you're using it, but usually when a chunk comes out like that, the correct way up, it's integration of information. There could be a lot of things that you're thinking about, a lot of things that you're processing right now. Yeah, see, look, the sun. There's a lot of things that is getting your attention and your energy right now. First off, there's opportunity. Okay, so this could be work opportunities, or this can be some kind of opportunity in which to take action. For some of you guys, the next card is the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so some of you guys may have the opportunity to close some doors and open some new ones. All I can say is that this is the time of luck. So something that you do could change your fortune. This opportunity, this can be a lucky change. The Wheel of Fortune is Jupiter. It's Jupiter in Sagittarius. It's basically luck. This is a lucky opportunity for you. I don't know if it's moving. If it's moving or if it's in terms of work or if this is lucky information that you're coming across. But it's also an opportunity to close the door on something and rise above. Completion of a cycle. It could be a discussion that opens new doors for you. Because three is about information, it's about childbirth, it's about ideas, it's about communication, communicating information that changes your luck and helps you rise above. And this is in terms of your career because we've got the sun here. So there's some energy, some focus, some attention being put towards an opportunity that you're being given. An opportunity to leave the past behind. An opportunity to devote your energy to your career. You may have to focus on your work more. The Wheel of Fortune is also a number 10. It's about completion of a cycle and holding space for the new and then beginning. So this is like, it's almost like a new job or a new opportunity or a new lucky career. Okay, next card, excuse me if you heard that. Okay, King of Wands is enthusiastic, dynamic energy. Can be very aggressive. This is like Aries energy, but it's a fire sign, so it can be Aries, it can be Sagittarius, it can be Leo. But since it's the King of Wands, it feels like Aries. Okay, so this is almost like the Sun and Uranus. There may be an opportunity to confront some issues in regards to your career. Maybe it's the issues of not having enough energy, or it may be, ooh, with the full moon in Virgo, it could be shifting your responsibilities in a way that serves you better so you don't feel so drained and that you can bring back the excitement in terms of what you do for a living. Or this could be a new career and somebody who's dynamic and energetic. This could be looking at a new career and throwing all your energy into your finances or into this opportunity that's coming to you. Okay. Oh, Prince of Wands and Four of Hearts. Okay, so there could be some excited communication. This could be impulsively saying, I'm not happy. Or this could be you going after what you want in your love relationships. You could be moving in with somebody. You could be moving in with somebody who is very bright, very sunny, very energetic, very career-oriented, a person of action. We got a lot of fire cards here, a lot of wands. So there's a lot of action, a lot of moving. The energy is vibrant, exciting, ambitious. Let's see what these are about. Seven of Swords. Oh, six. Okay, yeah, some of you guys may be moving towards something new, possibly a new challenge, looking for a way to shake things up in your career. You've been devoting a lot of attention to the things that would bring your energy back, ambitiously going after what you want after a period of thinking about it. You could be asking yourself if you deserve this opportunity, this chance, this lucky stroke, this lucky information, or this lucky job offer. Because it could have been an excited communication of a job offer. This could be somebody calling, letting you know that, hey, I got this cool new opportunity. And then we have the Eight of Pentacles and the Six of Swords reversed. Okay, so lesson learned. Take care of yourself. Don't throw yourself into the workaholic mode. We have North Node in Cancer and the South Node in Capricorn. Okay, so we're moving away from that workaholic male ego, okay? Of course, you could be bored at work. That's why you're doing something different. You create an opportunity, a lucky opportunity by yourself by doing something different and throwing your energy into doing something different. Of course, you could be bored at work. You could not want to work, or you could have taken a few days off from work because you needed to take care of yourself. And then you have the Six of Swords reverse. This is not a karmic lesson. This is just refining what we already started. Now, the full moon in Virgo was just yesterday, the 19th. So things should have came to completion about health practices that were started back September 9th last year when we had the new moon in Virgo, which was new ideas and how to take care of the self. Okay. Now, I remember around that time, I was getting overwhelmed, and I started closing the shop and not opening the door until 9 o'clock, and taking that half an hour to an hour before I opened the door to meditate and situate myself before I opened. And then I also started making sure that I take an hour lunch with the door closed and that I shut at exactly 5. Okay, and now that we had the full moon in Virgo just yesterday, now I am very resolute and taking the weekends off. I was working 6 days a week, but now I realize I, in addition to one day off, I need to have one day where I can run errands. So now I need to take 2 days off, and that is how we take better care of ourselves. Okay, being responsible for the self. It's a karmic lesson that has been learned. Okay, how to balance work and self-love. You were thinking of ways, not that you were thinking of ways not to work, but you were thinking about what was better for you in terms of your everyday schedule. Okay, there's a lot of attention being given to that. Okay, so you're learning your lesson and defining and refining your daily work habits, shaking things up, changing things up for the betterment of yourself, for the betterment of your health, okay? Because you do realize, you may on some level, Ask yourself, do I really deserve this opportunity? Am I really supposed to be here? Well, yes. The opportunity is being presented to you. The Magician. Okay, as above, so below. You manifested this opportunity. This is what you were waiting for. Okay. Use all your tools. Harness all your energy. And move to create what you want. So you were the one that brought about this opportunity. Okay, because you vibrated high. You were doing what you love. You put your attention, your time, your energy, and your love into doing what you love. You went after what you wanted, despite the voices in your head saying, you don't deserve this. You're like, I do. I've learned my lesson. I know what will serve me best. So we are willing the situation that we want. Okay, we got the opportunity. We're working with it. And we're creating more opportunities for ourselves. Okay, those are going to be the last cards I take because that's a lot. Okay, for once, some of us had to stand in our power and take care of ourselves and be self-reliant. We had to have the courage to stand up for ourselves. We got a lot of wands here. We got a lot of new beginnings. We've got the Magician. We've got Nine of Pentacles. That's all about taking care of the self. So even though you want to work, you want to do this, you want to put all your energy into the sun, know when you have to put it down and say, I got to take care of myself. So some of you guys may have taken a little vacation, a little bit of self-care. I know I did. And then what do we got? Ace of Pentacles, Ten of Hearts, Chariot, and Prince of Hearts reverse. So right now you guys are kind of lagging in the energy, like I was saying about the sun. You're putting all your energy into your work, but it's kind of lacking in the love relationships. I mean, you guys love each other, but you're not all over each other right now. There's money and a lot of thinking going on. So there's some issues that are being worked on that it's not that you don't love each other, but you guys are busy. You guys are busy creating something new and taking care of the self, making changes. And then we have Ace of Pentacles and the Ten of Hearts. Okay, so somebody's going to get rewarded here. Ace of Pentacles is like a windfall. It's a gift of money. And then we have Ten of Hearts, which is success, fulfillment, emotional fulfillment. So this new opportunity, this lucky opportunity that you have, it may get you some kind of bonus that's going to make you happy. Or this opportunity is what's making you happy. And because you're vibrating so high, you may have a new line of finances or some kind of financial reward. I feel like I should pull a couple cards from this deck for some reason. Oh, once again. Okay, so. Ace of Cups. Oh, beautiful. Oh, these couldn't be more beautiful cards, guys. All right, so Magician. You're creating as above, so below. Harnessing your energy and your willpower. The Three of Swords is about sorrow. You're not sorry. Previously, we were unconsciously creating. So there was a lot of, what the hell is this? Really, this is my reality. And once we realized that we had the we had the energy to create from the beginning, to consciously create, a lot of us have delved into the law of attraction and we've begun to move forward and create the life that we wanted. So this is about creating a life without sorrow. Okay, we've already had that sorry ass life and now we're creating I want to say a sorry free life. We are creating a new life with no sorrow. Okay, we've gone through a lot of sorrows. We've processed out a lot of griefs. We've been healing the ego. So this being reversed is like we're creating from a place without judgment, without ego. This is fresh. This is new. Then we have, oh wow, we have Ace of Cups. So this is new or renewed love. For some of you guys, this is a renewed love for yourself, okay? Taking care of the self, loving the self, forgiving the self. Only when you can love yourself that you can love someone else, okay? So work on being brave, forgiving yourself, living your best life, and loving yourself, okay? And your love will be attracted to you, because this is the big cup. This is real love. And then you also have the Six of Cups. So this could be your soulmate. When you start loving yourself, your soulmate will appear. This could also be somebody coming back from the past wanting to offer you real love. This is your true mate, your true twin flame. This is the one person where you guys can love each other and have freedom within the chains of a relationship, within the confinement of a relationship. This could also be like somebody coming back from the past to tell you that they love you. This is like auntie that you haven't seen for 30 years showing up and going, oh my gosh, I'm moving here. I love you so much. What are you doing tomorrow? You know, hooking up with a previous love or hooking up with somebody that you care about. And this is real true love. So it could be family, could be a relationship, somebody that you used to go with in this life or previous life, and you've manifested it by vibrating high and closing the door on the past. When you heal your heart, you are ready for the next step. Okay, and healing the heart involves forgiving yourself and then loving yourself. And that is when you'll be ready for your soulmate. Okay, when you are living your best life, independent, self-reliant, don't need validation. Nine is also unconditional love. So this is when you unconditionally love yourself. You are so filled, emotionally fulfilled, that you have enough love to give other people. Somebody's doing real good here. I like when the financial reward comes up. That's like somebody walking up and handing you money. I like when it's my reading and I get handed money. Hold on, a couple more cards. Okay, I'm just going to pull a couple more and then we're going to end this reading. Oh. Okay. So, first thing that comes out, Knight of Swords. Sorry, not sorry. Knight of Swords is about fighting for an idea. It fell out on the Ten of Hearts, the Three of Swords, and the Six of Cups. So this is like somebody's trying their best to believe that there's a love out there for them. Somebody's trying their best to believe that there is their true mate out there. This could be communication from a previous soulmate that's kind of like out of the blue. Hey, how you doing? Not very emotional, but peeking, fishing. Somebody coming back from the past to check on you, but very distant, cold in communication. It's like they're not sure if you even want to speak to them, or they could be calling you and you could be like, what do you want? Because as far as you're concerned, that has been closed out already and you're not sorry about that. you're already fulfilled. You're not interested in this person trying to pique your interest again. You already have love with the Ace of Cups. All right, let's see what we've got here. And these are this way, so these are reversed. Okay, so first of all, there's some secrets here. There's something that hasn't been spoken. There's something that might have to come out, that has to be revealed. There is a level of healing that still needs to be done. Okay, somebody has to, yeah. Okay, so Four Cups reversed and we have the Moon reversed. So there's some healing that needs to be done. Somebody, you haven't forgiven yourself, or you've forgiven yourself, but you haven't moved on to loving yourself. You're just doing you. And then we had the Page of Pentacles reversed. Okay, this is practicality. It's reversed, so it's like, this is not your practical message of money. This could be, message about money, practicality, reevaluating the love. This is like, you're not sure. If you really, well, this is you not being completely vulnerable. Page of Pentacles can be about communication. It's also about practicality. Then we have the Four of Hearts, which is about reevaluation and love. We have that here. So this is like not expressing yourself, not being practical, and not even thinking about what you want in love. It's almost like a previous relationship or a previous lover tried to come back and you said, what do you want? And it was like, you don't even have to think about it. It's not a secret anymore that you did not want this person. You're very distant and cold to this person who tried to communicate. Okay, guys. So we're going to pull a card from the Hawaiian Healing Intentions deck. So yeah, there is somebody trying to come back into their lives, and they're not interested. They're only interested in you, but unfortunately it's not a very passionate, loving time at the moment. It's basically a time for ambition and to put your energy where your career is, okay, because there's some things that are being refined. Malama, to honor, protect, and care for. Nurturing, okay? 4 and 3. It's about, it's grounding ideas. My intention is to nurture, honor, protect, and care for myself, and to create sacred space in my life for my authentic self to thrive. Okay, as noted with the 2 9 of Pentacles. Although nurturing your loved ones is important, nurturing yourself is critical. Honoring, protecting, and caring for yourself is the first and most important step towards being able to offer love and caring to others. That's exactly what I said, guys. Self-care enables you to develop your gifts, cultivate wellness, and be the beloved one. When you feel whole, healthy, and supported, you can thrive. And from that state of abundance, you can choose to nurture your loved ones. Okay, so yeah, it's all about the self-care, knowing what you want, knowing what you don't want, and sticking by your beliefs and consciously creating, guys. All right, I will see you guys next month. Love you guys. Take care.